This Headless Professor video is about the kinds of research design used in lifespan research. The central concept here is that of the cohort. A cohort is a population of individuals who were born during the same historical period. One frequently mentioned cohort or generation would be the baby boomers, born between 1946 and 1964. This cohort is extremely important because it happens to be one of the largest cohorts in history, more individuals in that cohort than any other. Another example of cohort breakdown would be if you're working in a VA hospital. You see a real difference between the veterans that represent different war periods. The World War II veterans, those of the Korean conflict, Vietnam, the Gulf War, and more recently, Iraq and Afghanistan. There's two basic methods for lifespan research, cross-sectional and longitudinal. Each one of these has advantages and disadvantages for the researcher. The basic logic of cross-sectional research is a separate group's design. Your sample will include people from at least two different cohorts, and then we will compare these different cohorts. So in effect, you would be surveying people of different ages, young and old, at the same time, and then comparing the two. To graphically represent this, let's suppose that these blue represent individuals of one cohort, a very young cohort, and these red individuals represent a different cohort. So we would then compare them on some measure of attitude or performance and see what the differences might be. One of the problems, of course, in running this type of research would be that of confounding factors. You see, these individuals of different ages, because they do come from different cohorts, they differ not only in age, but they also differ in terms of the kinds of historical experiences that were unique for their particular cohort. These present confounding independent variables, and it becomes very difficult to infer which factor, age or the historical differences, is the actual cause of the differences in attitudes or performance. The other approach is to do a longitudinal research project. Here we take just one cohort, and we study it over a long time period. So we measure them at time one, we wait a number of years, and then we reassemble our sample and measure them again in time period two. So let's take this young blue sample, and let's measure them on some variable today. And we see that we have a sample size of 5, and then we're going to come back, 20, 30, 40, 50 years later, when they're nice and big, and we're then going to measure them again and see how they might have changed over the years. Well, one thing I noticed is, although they're all bigger now, we don't have everybody we started off with. I thought we started off with a little bit more. Well, we might have lost somebody, and that would be the process of attrition. Attrition is the central problem of longitudinal designs, because those people who finally show up for our retest are not necessarily representative of the entire sample. Indeed, those people who survive will not be representative. People who have certain mental or physical problems will be more likely to die sooner and not be present for our final sample. Those then are the basic methods of research for the lifespan, cross-sectional and longitudinal. Each has its own set of problems that we have to be aware of.